आई एम प्रोफेसर विवेक साठे ऑफ डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ मैकेनिकल इंजीनियरिंग वालचंद इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी सोलापुर। ऑलरेडी वी हैव फिनिश टू सेशंस और टू वीडियोस इन विच यू हैव लर्न्ड द नेसेसरी कंडीशन एंड सफिशिएंट कंडीशन फॉर द करेक्टरिस्टिक इक्वेशन टू बी स्टेबल एंड वी हैव कैटेगोरिकली मेंशन दैट फॉर एनी मैथमेटिकल पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू you must have both the things satisfied, necessary as well as sufficient condition. Now today we are going to learn the Rouse table and analyze the given characteristic equation using that particular say table. So at the end of this session you will be able to prepare Rouse table. I am sure that you can do it, and from that you can draw the conclusion also, and after that we are going to discuss about the various say errors that are involved in the Rouse stability criteria. Okay, now you can see today's task is preparation of Rouse stability table or Rouse table. We have seen that necessary condition and sufficient conditions are same for any polynomial. The only thing is that up to quadratic, necessary condition is also sufficient condition, because we have taken example of a quadratic. Because in a quadratic, advantage is that whenever we write a quadratic equation, if the signs of all are positive or negative, roots are always going to be negative. That is, they are on the left side, guarantedly. You take any quadratic, and if the roots are complex, they will be on the left half of the S-plane. So necessary and sufficient condition is satisfied, that is quadratic is complete and roots are on the left side. Whether they are real or complex, it doesn't matter, but system is going to be stable. Then we have learned a cubic equation in the previous video, and for the cubic, initially we were having some trouble because we saw that a cubic equation was given and it was a complete equation, means it contained all the terms of cube, square, s square and s to 0 term. But the problem was that was not a stable system. And how we could identify? We identified it by finding out its factors, and after finding the factors we obtained the roots. The possibility for the roots for a cubic are various. All the three may be real, one may be real, two may be imaginary, or one is real, two imaginary roots may be same. Then there may be two real roots same, one is another third real root. Out of this, whatever the combination is there, whatever the values of roots we get, we are comfortable to call it stable when all the roots are on the left half of the S-plane. But for that particular problem that we had discussed, the polynomial was complete. Complete in the sense, it contained cubic term, square term, s raised to 1 term and s raised to 0 term. And another problem, necessary condition was that all the coefficients must have same sign. So it also satisfied that condition. So when my equation or a polynomial which is greater than degree 2, see what is important word, greater than degree 2 is not guaranteedly stable if it satisfies necessary condition. So this is what we are going to learn today. In the previous video, we have tested it that yes, we are getting roots on the right hand side. Then today we are learning the basis for it, and if that is the case, how to do it. Now just imagine it was a cubic equation, you could factor it. Suppose it is a sixth order equation, how to factor it is a big task. If it is a 15th order equation, how to factor it? So it is difficult. So for a 15th order equation, if I ask you that check whether the system is stable or not, then what you will do? You will factor it, you will get all the 15th roots. Then we'll plot them on the paper and see that all the roots are coming on the left hand side, and therefore system is stable. So that is a very big task. So even if you do it computationally with the help of your computer, it takes lot of computational effort. And always remember, some things which can be done elegantly should be done elegantly. That is called as way of solving a problem. Otherwise, by enumeration we can solve the problem, means just go on finding out the factors and take the values. Or suppose the range is given to you, put on the values of that particular expression and check whether we get the particular value positive or negative. But that is not the way to solve the problem. So Rouse developed a table, and he made it very necessary condition that your equation must satisfy the necessary condition. And always remember, we prepare Routh's table even the system is stable, not stable or marginally stable, because from the Routh's table we get the idea whether my system is marginally stable or not. By finding out the values of roots on the left hand side, whether they are there or not, I don't get an idea whether my system is going to be marginally stable or not, or what is the critical frequency of vibration for the system that is allowed. But if I prepare Routh's table, I can get a better idea. So how the Routh's table is prepared? So first thing is, he says that write the equation that is given to you, a polynomial equation, in decreasing order. In decreasing order means what? So if it is a, for your understanding, I have taken 8th order polynomial. You write here 8th order polynomial, 8th order here, then 7th, 6th, 5th power, 4th, 3rd, 2nd, 1 and 0. Now remember, I may give you a numerical or a problem in which some part is missing. So as far as your analysis is concerned, you may say that, sir, as there is one term is missing, the system is going to be unstable. Okay, no problem. System is unstable, I agree. But you do the table, complete it, and then we can see that, yes, if it is unstable, whether it is a marginally stable or unstable. So that idea we can get only with the help of Routh's criteria. So for that, Routh says that you write the particular say, equation in the descending order. Then what to do if any one term is missing? You write 0 for that. You write 0 as a coefficient for that. Suppose s raised to 6 term is missing, you write a naught s raised to 5, 8, a 1 s raised to 7, 0 s raised to 6 and further. But assume that this is given to you. Then what is the table structure? Then you write here the powers of s in the decreasing order. So s raised to 8, s raised to 7 and so on, we move in this way. 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1 and 0. Okay, then what we do, as this is a polynomial, it is a complete polynomial. Whether it is not complete, if the problem, given problem is not complete, we are making it complete by making the coefficient 0. That is mandatory. So as far as this equation is table is concerned, this is my complete polynomial. Some terms may be 0, say coefficient. Suppose this constant term is not there, so we have to write that 0. Suppose a raised to 4 coefficient is not present, s raised to 4 term is absent, you write 0 into s raised to 4. So for me, all the terms are present. So if it is 8th order equation, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9 terms are there. That is simple. For a quadratic, we have got 3 terms. For a cubic, we have got 4 terms. For a quartic, we have got 5 terms. Similarly, nth order polynomial, will have n plus 1 terms. So 8th order polynomial will have 9 terms, is it not? So he says that after writing this in the vertical direction, s raised to 8 to s raised to 0, what we have to do? We have to first write the coefficients of odd number terms. This is first term, this is third term, this is fifth term, this is seventh term, and this is ninth term. See, I have underlined with blue color the terms. See, I have not taken the looking at the power. Power may be even. But this is the odd term. Why odd term? Because if I write here, this is my first term, this is my second term, this is my third term, this is my fourth term, this is my fifth term, sixth, seventh, eighth and ninth term. So out of these nine terms, how many odd terms I have got? 1, 3, 5, 7 and 9. 1, 3, 5, 7 and 9. So what I will do as a first case, I will write here in the first line the all odd term number coefficients a naught, then a2, then a4, then a6, 1, 2, 3, 4 and a8. So this is my first term, third term coefficient, fifth, seventh and ninth. Okay. Then what I tell you, then you write down the even number terms. Then you write the even number terms. So these are the even number terms. I will make them circle, even number terms. Okay, so they are a1, a3, a5 and a7. When it is not there, you can just put a dash or you can take it at 0 for your calculation. Then Routh said that if you prepare this, you make the next row by multiplying this, subtracting this and divide it by this pivot. So the first element in this row, will be a1 a2 minus a0 a3 divided by a1. For this a1 a4 minus a0 a5, divided by still a1. So likewise you can prepare the table. Then we'll call these numbers as b1, b2 and so on. Then for our next table, this is our first row and this is our second row. For next, this is first row and this is second row, and you can proceed in this particular way. So you can very easily prepare the rows table and do the calculations. So this is just say structure I have given, very simple. First write odd number terms, coefficients, then even number coefficients. Then for this third row, a1 a2 minus a0 a3 divided by pivot element. For second term, a1 a4 minus a0 a5 divided by a1. Third, a1 a6 minus a0 a7 divided by a1, and likewise. What will happen? The last answer s0 will be always equal to a8, remember. So this is your check that you can make. If you get this a8 here, then your table preparation is correct. Otherwise, there is some mistake in the calculation. Okay. So this part is important in our further discussions, because we are going to discuss what are the how to make the do the analysis of this particular table, and what are the comments that we can make on Routh's table. Now you have got a mastery over this particular say analysis. If you want to go for further reading, you can go for Raven, Bakshi and Barpatte. Thank you for patience listening. In the next two videos, we will discuss type 1 and type 2 errors that we come across in the stability analysis. Thank you.